नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम्। नित्यानंदेश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरुपरंपराम्। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the living, practicing Hindus from all over the world. I welcome all the Sarvajna Peetha Kartas, Yajamans, visitors, viewers, Shrimahans, Mahans, Sarvaparityagis, Kotaris, Tanedar, everyone sitting with us all over the world. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Paramashiva's direct message from Kailasa. Understand the cosmic principles about birth, death, life, universe, God, human society. Understand the cosmic principles about all these basic ingredient of your life. Function from that understanding, you will have cosmic consciousness happening in you. This is today's message. Understand? Understand about life from cosmos. As cosmos reveals about life, not as the foolish materialistic brainwashing dash 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 fellows are trying to teach you. You see, the chronic capitalists are trying to brainwash you. Life is all about the amount of luxury and comforts and things you have, because they want to make you just their customer. The only utility you have for them is just being a customer. Earn, 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 come and give it to us to buy a jeans. Then come and give it to us to buy a couch. Then come and give it to us to buy a car. Then earn for 30 years, go on paying just the mortgage of your home. You are nothing but machine to pay their bills. So they teach you. That is what is life. Each one teaches about life to you the way they can exploit you. But cosmos teaches about life to you as it is. I tell you, I have seen the delusion of the people. Fear of living organized, they will even commit suicide, but they don't want to live organized way. See, the whole cosmos is order. It is in such beautiful order. Even the chaos is in a very beautiful order. If you learn that order, you will understand life is such absolute freedom. For example, when you wake up early in the morning, if you just remember Paramashiva, your whole brain will wake up, your whole body will wake up, your whole mind will wake up, your whole consciousness will wake up, your whole emotions will wake up. It is equivalent to having 25 coffees. Remembering the 25 faces of Paramashiva, 75 eyes, 50 hands, and meditating on him, Mahadeva, manifest in me, is equivalent to having 25 coffees. Ooh, you will become hyperactive. I have seen these kids, when you feed them too much of chocolate, they will become hyperactive. Now, without even eating chocolate, Skandamata is doing that job. She is making the whole ashram chaos. I am so happy. Just remembering that she is Subramanya, she is just making everyone run around. It's called sugar bus. I tell you. Remember Paramashiva and have sugar bus. Your whole day will be in such order. Morning sugar bus of your life should be remembering Paramashiva with 25 heads, 75 eyes, 50 hands. Mahadeva. Hara Hara Mahadeva. Paramashiva. That should be your sugar bus. Understand? From the time I know me, my sugar bus is Arunachala's Darshan. Actually, when I look back, I feel I have not changed at all. This description is the most apt description for me. Small, but continuous, unbroken lineage of enlightened masters. From a remote South Indian village, Thiruvannamalai, gone right. I can repeat this definition any number of times. Is Nityananda. I don't feel I have changed at all. See, whether the Bhasma filled forehead or Rudraksha filled body or the way I sit in Bhatmasana and the cloth up to knee. If you see my Yoga Pattabhishekam photo, 1994, I think the photo was taken a little early during the ritual time, some of the ritual, and this final declaration day that photo was used. 1994, the Yoga Pattabhishekam photo. And now, I don't feel I have changed at all. Those days, when I wake up, the first thing I'll open my eyes, seeing Arunachala. Now, I am already in Samadhi. So, first thing, I open my eyes as Paramashiva. That's it. Otherwise, I don't see any difference. See, whether Kailasa, this Sangha. Kailasa is nothing but Arunachala gone right. That's all. Reviving Arunachala, that's all. All over the world. Listen. You can see that photo. And now, nothing has changed. Last 26 years. Listen. about death. Learn about death from cosmos. Who knows you before your death, during death, after your death, and what is death process? Learn everything from cosmos. Beautifully, cosmos has revealed all the sacred truths in Upanishads and Vedas and Agamas. I tell you, when you learn, understand, intranalyze Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana, listening, intranalyzing, manifesting. These great truths from cosmos, your consciousness becomes enlightened consciousness. You just know life as it should be known. Yesterday I saw so many posts about, only now we are understanding Krishna's sacrifice. Hey, I tell you, even his Rasa Leela is an extreme sacrifice. It is not womanizing or polygamous as dash, dash, dash fellows distort. The illegitimate sons of 3 M's. Distort Krishna's life, Rama's life, and abuse Hindus, make Hindus feel respect for their tradition and civilization. As they describe, it is neither womanizing nor polygamous. Understand? Hey, first of all, the whole Rasalila happened when Krishna was a kid, not even 10 year old. Before 10, he already moved to Mathura. The whole thing happened in Vrindavan before 10. Unless he is real, all right, let me not get into that subject. Now let me only tell what I need to tell, because I have very spicy words for this anti-Hindu gang. I just silence myself. Okay, let me do my work, creative work, because Krishna Janmashtami is coming. So let me explain about Krishna and induce more love, bhakti, devotion about Krishna, and let you all start manifesting Krishna. Let's enjoy Krishna. Let's celebrate Krishna. Why waste time on gamsas and sisubalas and bloody dash, 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 dash. Narakasuras. No, no need. Let them live their life. Let us live our life. Listen. Everything about Krishna's life is absolute sacrifice. Sarva parityaga for the humanity. Whether
He gave life to the 16,000 women whom he rescued from Narakasura's hell. Or he himself created a controlled condition and diffused all the weapons, most dangerous weapons, and all those people who can multiply those weapons finished them off, killed them, literally eliminated them. So planet Earth is safe. Planet Earth again becomes a place to live. Killing Bhishma, killing Drona was basic requirement. Because anyone goes and begs, serves Drona, he is going to teach them Brahmastra. And after learning that Brahmastra, whether that fellow is going to be dharmic or just going to justify his delusional arrogance as dharma, who knows? So killing Drona was absolute necessary. Killing Bhishma was absolute necessary. Krishna took everything upon himself. That is why I wanted the Partha Sarathi form of Krishna to be worshipped. Only then you will understand his sacrifice, where he is just resting in the beach of Chennai. Salty air burns the wounds but heals quickly. That is why he went to the Triplicane. He went to Triplicane and rested there for recovery of all the wounds from the body after the war. I want the Partha Sarathi form of Krishna to be worshipped. To remember the extreme sacrifice, even physically. Hey, don't think he was all the time being served by Gopikas and all his Ashtasakis, always in the bed with best food, dress, comforts and best women. No. Stop projecting your fantasies on him. He was extremely sincere, compassionate, integrated leader, acharya, guide. Training people. Finally, he gave his own Narayani Sena to fight against him. He is in Pandava's side and he gifted his Narayani Sena to Gauravas. And Narayani Sena did a very integrated job. They did not drop their weapons because Krishna is on the other side. They obeyed his words than their personal attachment to him. What a personality he built. That is Krishna. His own people take his words more important, his command is important than their personal attachment to him. God. And they also know nothing can be done to him. He is too big. If you look deeper and deeper Krishna's life, I can understand how a man who knows life as it should be known from cosmos, lives and radiates, manifests the extreme tyaga, sacrifice. Finally, he accepts the curse of Gandhari. Actually, he could have rejected the curse of Gandhari. It is not that all curses affect him. No. A Brahmastra did not affect him. He could save Parikshit from Brahmastra. The stupid Ashwatthama sends Brahmastra. Krishna says, stop. And Brahmastra stops. He gives life back to Parikshit. So even Brahmastra he can nullify. He could have just nullified the Gandhari's curse. But he says, no, I want to honor the pain of Gandhari by honoring her curse. And he sacrifices Yadukula. And he knows Yadukula is going to be destroyed. So he gives his body to Suryavamsa, the Kalinga was ruled by Suryavamsa. He gives his body to them and tells them, hey, you maintain my Jiva Samadhi, my temple. The Jagannath temple is the place where Krishna, Balarama, Subhadra's bodies physically is in Jiva Samadhi. The deity represents, see, the body, after Krishna leaves the body, it floats in the ocean and goes to that side as directed by him. That body filled with the salt water. Natural mummification. Then all the three bodies were recovered by the Suryavamsa Rajas and they build the temple and they are maintaining it. And it's a living deity. I tell you, Krishna is alive in Jagannath. Subhadra is alive in Jagannath. Balabhadra is alive in Jagannath. If you want to see Krishna directly, face to face, go to Jagannath. Go to Puri. He is alive, living, sakshat, pratyakshamurti. Ramanuja is sitting as he is, with heart beat in Srirangam. I am talking to my disciples. I am not interested in trolls. Listen, I have seen that deity of Ramanuja in Srirangam. He is living. When I went to have darshan, I bowed down and I had one small desire. Prabhu, just show me you are alive. He sweetly opened his eyes and a small smile and closed it and went into samadhi again. Understand? I am uttering these words responsibly. All my disciples who are integrated to me, sincerely who believes, who loves what I am talking, go to Srirangam, stand in front of Ramanuja and ask him, Prabhu, my guru sent me. He told me, you smiled at him and opened your eyes and gave darshan. Please do that to me again. Please do that. Bless me. I sincerely trust my guru's words and I came here. I am here for your darshan. Hey, I tell you. Now I give you the commitment. If Ramanuja gave me darshan, if that is truth, he will give you the same darshan and blessing. He is alive. Body has shrunk a little bit, is larger than when he was using his body, was little larger figure, a well built Ajanubhahu, because the Adisesha's avatar, larger body. Now body has little shrunk, but is alive. Acharya is alive. Understand? I have no reason to lie. I have no reason to lie. What is there? What is the vested interest for me to promote Acharya Ramanuja Samadhi? Nothing. I have no reason. And the temple is not in my control. That I am promoting it, so all of you will come and lot of money will come and it will all be mine and all stupid trolls. Shut all your holes and go and do your work, some other work, not trolling me. I have nothing to gain by promoting Ramanuja's Jiva Samadhi. I am just telling all my sincere disciples who are interested in enlightenment, don't miss, at least once go there and see, and I really tell you, he will bless you. Hey, listen, he is a living Mahapurusha. Even when I went to Shiradi, I saw he was sitting, just sitting. Shiradi Sai Baba. He was just sitting. Hey, it is not deity, he is. I am not hypomania or delusionary person who sees something which is not there. Hey, I see things which you can't see does not mean I see things which is not there. I see more than what you can see. Multiple times I went to Srirangam. Just now I connected with Acharya and prayed, Prabhu, please bless anyone who comes in my name listening to this satsang. Please grace them, make them realize you are alive. He said, Tathastu. Done. Only after I got his Tathastu, I am even telling all of you, declaring it to all of you. Go. If you ask anybody in the Srirangam, they will tell you that where Ramanuja's Samadhi is there. And all my Gurukul kids, Balasans and my sannyasis, Kailasavasis, you should not miss. As early as the travel becomes possible, all of you should make a trip. If you have not already made a trip, you should make a trip. And people who are in India, of course, from other countries, I don't think it is possible now, especially with this corona Arana, all that. Hmm. So at least people, Kailasvasis in India, when you are able to travel, when the traveling is possible, you should make a trip and ask him, Prabhu, Swamiji sent me. He told, you are alive. Just show some way. Either he can move hands and that, let him decide. Or just open his eyes and or a smile. I tell you, he responds. He's alive, sitting in samadhi. Sayujya Mukti of Parandama. Let me come back to the subject. The cosmic principles about life, death, enlightenment, purpose of life, internalize all of that. Upanishad, Kathopanishad very clearly shows what is death? In a beautiful way, I have spoken multiple number of times, elaborately giving detailed understandings and revealing. Listen to all those satsangs and classes and read. Same way this different states of consciousness and different planes of the universe, 11 dimensions, 25 states of consciousness, 25 faces of Paramashiva. Internalize all of that. From that, you will grow a powerful, conscious way of existing. Krishna's Tyaga, organized whole Hinduism, and saved planet Earth from the worst disasters. Krishna avoided thousands of atomic wars. Understand? At the time of Mahabharata war, at least I'm saying 10 people had the capacity to destroy the whole Srishti. Whole Srishti. Most brilliant strategist Krishna. Diffused, dismantled, destroyed all the weapons. He did multiple things. Some weapons he diffused, some he destroyed, some he dismantled. But saved the planet Earth. I tell you. Powerful weapons like Brahmastra, ब्रह्मशीर्षास्त्र नारायणास्त्र ब्रह्मांडास्त्र भार्गवास्त्र पाशुपदास्त्र ईच वन ऑफ देम कैन फिनिश ऑफ होल प्रकृति होल क्रिएशन होल सृष्टि इस एक्सट्रीम त्याग ही कंपाइल्स द होल हिंदुइज्म इनटू वन बुक भगवद्गीता एक्चुअली ए पर्सनालिटी हु कैन स्पेल आउट भगवद्गीता ही एक्चुअली डेमॉन्स्ट्रेट्स ही इज एन एब्सोल्यूट कंट्रोल ऑफ हिमसेल्फ ही इज नॉट एट ऑल एजिटेटेड and leading the whole war. That is the definition of a real warrior. That is why in death bed Bhishma sings Sahasranama Vishnu Sahasranama glorifying Krishna who put him in death bed. Bhishma knows it is only Krishna who can put him on death bed. And lying on death bed, Bhishma delivers Vishnu Sahasranama. Vishwam Vishnur Vashatkaro Bhuta Bhavyabhavat Prabhu. The whole Vishnu Sahasranama is more a stuti to Krishna because you can see so much of Krishna in that Vishnu Sahasranama. More than any other incarnations, so much Krishna is present in Vishnu Sahasranama. If you see whole Lalita Sahasranama, so much Meenakshi will be present. The first this itself Shri Mata Shri Maharagni Srimat Simhasaneshwari Chidagnigunda Sambhuta Devakarya Samudyata Udyat Banu Sahasrapa Koti Banu Samanvita. The whole description walking out of the Chidagni Gunda Homa Gunda. The whole description of Lalita Sahasranama is about Meenakshi and Meenakshi's life. Because Adi Shankara manifested Lalita Sahasranama in Madurai. That is why the whole Lalita Sahasranama is Meenakshi's form of Parashakti. This whole Vishnu Sahasranama is Krishna's manifestation of Vishnu. The Vishnu Sahasranama Bhashya is Krishna's life. Lalita Sahasranama Bhashya is Meenakshi's life. I have done enough research to claim Meenakshi and Krishna were on the same timeline because at least 10 references I have. Meenakshi's father means who did yagna and birthed Meenakshi. Meenakshi herself, she did not stay in the womb of any human being. She just walked out of the Chidagni Gunda, means the Homa Gunda, and that exact place is only now our Shyamala Peeta, Sarvanya Peeta is there, and we have Puranic reference and the original references for that also, and Shastra reference, and even this, the father of Meenakshi, who did this yagna and birthed Meenakshi, died in Mahabharata war, Malayadvaja Pandya. And we have the original scriptural references from Itihasa. Only the fools, stupid fellows who call the whole Hindu itihasas as mythology. Those fools only deny all this. These are all simple, straight, recorded facts, more authentic than the Indian media now. 1,000 times more authentic and truthful than the Indian media, the most corrupt media in the world, or I should say one of the most corrupt media in the world is Indian media. All our Puranas, Itihasas are 1,000 times more truthful than any of the media stories you read today. How the Indian media is trying to destroy the whole Hinduism and Hindu India, the Hindu Bharat is being raped and destroyed by the Indian media. I can give you the original references even now, the Itihasas, which proves Meenakshi's father was killed in Mahabharata war, and actually Meenakshi's father's father was killed by Krishna in a war, and Malayadvaja Pandya, Meenakshi's father, takes the oath he will kill Krishna, but finally they understand and come to a settlement and peace. And then the Malayadvaja becomes very devoted to Krishna and he wages war from Pandava's side. And during the war, he is killed. The king Malayadvaja has numerous references in the epic Mahabharata. His father Kulasekara Pandya was said to have been killed by Krishna, Lord Krishna, and his country invaded. To avenge the death of his father, Prince Malayadvaja got weapons from Bhishma, Drona, Balarama and Kripacharya. Then the Prince Malayadvaja is said to become in weapons the equal of Rukmi, Karana and Arjuna and Achyuta. He then desired to destroy the city of Dwarka, Krishna's capital, and subjugate the whole world. Sage Agastya and Varuna, however, counseled him against the decision and said to have granted him back his father's kingdom and made king. He is said to have, not said to have, I think all this said to have is the bloody British translation. Malayadvaja got his capital back and got his father's kingdom, means that Pandya kingdom back, and he became king again. And he was also present during the Swayamvara of Draupadi and brought jars of sandalwood, agarbatti perfumes, and jars of gold for Yudhishthira's Rajasuya. During the Gurukshetra war, he sided with Pandava, and also he is mentioned as a mighty and powerful charioteer and warrior. He was killed by Kaurava's Ashwatthama, and he became a great devotee of Krishna after being advised by Agastya and Varuna. And because Agastya and Varuna are literally the founders of this Pandya kingdom, Varuna guides the Manu's ark, that ship after the deluge, and Matsyavatara brings that ark and parks in Pandya kingdom. Then Agastya comes and revives the whole civilization. Agastya was also in Manu's ark. So Varuna and Agastya are literally the founders of Pandya kingdom, and that is why the Pandya kingdom also has the fish as their emblem. That fish is Matsyavatara. Matsyavatara, Krishna's, Vishnu's incarnation, which brought the ship and parked. The Pandya kingdom. All these are history. Unless you are illegitimate sons of 3M, you won't call this as myth. It's not mythology, it's all history. There is enough reference. Itihasas are historical documentation, records, more truthful than any media record. Like how these modern day illegitimate sons of 3M go on, try to claim there was never a mentioned word of Hindu in any ancient scriptures, this word, there's no such thing as Hindu religion. How many times you fellows will vomit the same shit? And I have enough reference. In the Shastras, we have been called as Hindus. Again, now I can give you 4 references. But these illegitimate sons of 3M will never go for any original scripture or reference. They just blabber. I'll give you the references we have to prove that we have been described as Hindus in our scriptures. The Meru Tantra, 33rd Prakasha in Saptakalpadruma. Paschimamnaya mantrastu prokta parasya bhashaya. Ashtotra sadasidir yesham samsadanat kalau. Panchakana saptamaura. Navasaha mahabala. Hindu dharmam. प्रलोप्तारा जायन्ते चक्रवर्तिनः हीनञ्च दूषयत्येव हिन्दुरित् युच्यते प्रिये. ट्रांसलेशन इन कलियुग बाय चैंटिंग द पश्चिमाम्नाय मंत्र फॉर 80,008 टाइम्स विल मैनिफेस्ट एस पावर किंग्स वाइस 5 काणा 7 मौरा एंड 9 साहा who will destroy the Hindu dharma. O Devi, the word Hindu literally means, O those who defeat the evil. And next, I have multiple references. I'll post everything in the Facebook, because there's a lot of confusion going on all the time. This illegitimate sons of 3M try to attack our identity as Hinduism and as Hindus. I'm giving you the Shastra Pramanas, the original references, which is at least 3,000-4,000 years old. Scriptures, Itihasas, Brihaspatiya Shastra Pavishya Purana. Himsaya duyate yascha sadacharana tatpara vedako pratimaseki sa hindu muha varnabak. Yar himsikkappattalum evan dukkamadigirano ulukkamana vaalkai nadathuvadil munaippudan ullano vedam pasu vigrahangal aagiyavatrai bhaktiyudan vazhipadugirano avane hindu. It's a beautiful translation. I read out in Tamil. I'll give the English translation also and put it in the Facebook with the reference, the original verse names the
the verse details, then Brihaspatyagama, which is before Christ, 400 years before Christ, the accepted dating itself is 400 years before Christ, but I feel these datings are much earlier. Even the Western historians, accepted date is before Christ, 400 years before. It says very clearly, Himalayam mudal Hindu Mahasagaram varai virindu parandu kidakkum devargalal nirmanikkappatta inda desam Hindustanam endra alaikkappadum. Janustane Jaina sapta sapta sindhu tataivacha hipta hindur yavaniya punarnyeyo kurundika. சா என்ற எழுத்து யவ்வனர்களின் பாஷையில் ஹா என்று திரிந்து சப்த சிந்து சப்த ஹிந்துவாய் மாறியது. இது பவிஷ்ய புராணம். ஈவன் திஸ் இஸ் 400 இயர்ஸ் பிஃபோர் கிரைஸ்ட். ஒன் ஆஃப் த பிகஸ்ட் ப்ராப்ளம் வித் திஸ் இல்லெஜிட்டிமேட் சன்ஸ் ஆஃப் 3M, ஒன்லி டு அபியூஸ் ஹிந்துயிசம் தே வில் அக்செப்ட் த ஹிந்து ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ் பட் நாட் டு கெட் த ஹிஸ்டாரிக்கல் டீடைல்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃபேக்ட்ஸ். கலினா பலினா கலித கலௌ நும் தர்மா எவ்வனையோ ரதாமாக்ரராஜ்தா ஹிந்தவோ விந்திய மகாவினா. காளிகா புராணம் இன் திஸ் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அட்லீஸ்ட் 2000 இயர்ஸ் ஓல்ட். அதர்ம ஆக்கிரமிப்பாளர்களின் படையெடுப்புகளினால் ஏற்படும் பாதிப்புகளிலிருந்து தப்பிக்க ஹிந்துக்கள் விந்தியமலையை கடந்து வந்தார்கள். That's all. So understand, I'll give all these translation, original verse and Sanskrit translation, sorry, English translation with the numbers and references of the slokas in the Facebook. Just read. These illegitimate sons of 3M, they don't bother about the real history at all. What they talk is more like a masturbation. They just talk and they are satisfied and go to sleep. That's it. They don't care about shastras, any reference or answers. It's not that they want to do a very research. It's not that they are interested in truth. It is they are interested in just masturbating and vomiting something. They blabber and okay. But all my disciples who are very sincere and interested in finding the truth, I am giving you the references and the truths. Take it and spread it to whoever wants to listen to the truth. Whoever is interested in their masturbation, let them go and be with. We are not interested. Whoever is interested in truth, they can come and you can give them the truth as it is. Learn about states of consciousness. I have given elaborately all these understandings in Paramashivoham classes, Sadashivoham, Mahasadashivoham, Paramashivoham classes, on 11 dimensions of the universe, vertical time zones, and 25 states of consciousness. In all these elaborate satsangs and classes, learn life from those right sources to know life as it is, as it should be known. Spend a little time in knowing life and cosmos. It's worth
I am telling you, it's worth. There is a lot more to tell. Maybe in the further satsangs. Now, with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam. The state, space, powers, being, superconsciousness, and Kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.